Hey guys, Mike here, out on another adventure. I'm here with Carol. She's going to be in the green boat. Simone will be in the orange boat, and George in the yellow. Me in this fancy new Delta 15.5 GT, courtesy of Mission Paddle Sports. We are out here on Desolation Sound. So we're at Oakover Arm right now. Just finished loading up all the boats. We got in last night into Lund. We were supposed to start from Lund, and it was pouring rain, windy, and just nasty. So we said, you know what, let's just camp here. Get a nice fresh start in the morning. It was a long drive up anyways, so it wasn't worth paddling an hour in pouring rain to set up in pouring rain when we could set up in the provincial campsite. So yeah, we set up there last night, took a little rest, and now it's 12:30. We've got a little bit of a slow start today, but beautiful day, medium winds, and we're about to head out. We're gonna see if we can make the Kurme Islands today, but we're 2.5 hours behind our original schedule, so we'll see how it goes. And we'll get to where we get to. We've got 7 days to just enjoy. So anyways, I'll get back to you in a bit once we're on the water. We are on the water. It's 1 o'clock. Just waiting for George to get in his boat, I believe. And we're headed for Feather. What was it called? Feather Cove? Feather Point? There we go. Hair Point. Headed for Hair Point. Past Boundary Rock. Code Peninsula, Code Island. Edith Island. Jolly good. Catch up with Simone. See how this Delta 15.5 GT paddles. So we just passed a gentleman paddling back, and I asked him where he was coming from, and he said the Kurmes. And I said, how busy is it? He said there's a school group headed there, a large group headed there right now, and they're quite a ways ahead of us. We had a quick chat, and we don't want to be hanging out with a school group on a small set of islands. So what are we thinking? Head up to Hair Point for rest, and then over to Feather Cove. Yeah, it's supposed to be empty.
It's supposed to be really pretty.
No campfires. No. Well, same as Kurmes, there's no campfires, so. Okay. So we'll head over there, and then we'll see how things look. Yeah, I would say the house on the orange roofed house on the left.
Yep. That's the boat.
So that's what we're doing.
beside us is what looks like a salmon farm. Back into the wind again.
Yeah.
Just enough breeze to keep it cool. Oyster farms usually had, the ones I saw had barrels, but I don't know. Anyways.
That was an oyster farm.
Oh, okay.
There were floating baskets about this deep.
Full of oysters?
Hey?
Full of oysters?
Yeah, just little tiny ones. You can see them growing. Some of the cages had bigger oysters.
Okay.
Some had looked like just starters.
And they must just keep them in there until they grow and the red tide dies off in the winter, and then harvest
them. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, this is incredible. Yeah, here comes the wind. Chop. Okay, so we have arrived at Hare Point. And we're going to check it out and see if this is where we're going to stay. George's tent was wet from last night's rain, so if we can get an extra hour of tent drying time, that would be good. The sun is definitely out, nice and warm. So, crystal clear water here.
Wow.
So, let them get out, and I'll get out, and we'll... A little explore. I'm not sure that I see ideal hammock trees anywhere, but I've got a tent, so. Sunday, 5:45. Going for an evening paddle. Camp is set up. Hammock is up. I got a hammock two nights in a row. Carol got her hammock two nights in a row. So we're excited about that. We've got our picnic table set up.
It's a tablecloth, dude. You gotta talk about the tablecloth.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, Simone just saying, talk about the tablecloth. We got beautiful red and white checkered tablecloth. And when we get back, we're going to have hot dogs, Caesar salad, and whatever else we can eat to lighten our food load, because we have enough food for a month. Between the four of us, we've got 15 bagels. About 3 blocks of cheese, 2 pounds of bacon. It's a little bit ridiculous. Cream cheese, smoked salmon. Smoked kokanee. Ugh. We got everything. Who had my smoked cocaine? Did I have that, or did it go in someone else's cooler bag?
Simone got it in her bag.
Yeah, I got it in mine.
Okay.
And tonight, I think, smoking would be good.
Smoking?
Smoking fish.
Eating smoked fish, yes. Yes, I want a charcuterie with the smoked fish and the crackers again.
And cream cheese, and,
yeah. Oh. Yeah, we're really roughing it out here. Tomorrow we're gonna have hash browns, bacon, and eggs again. Okay. Anyway, so yeah. Head out for an evening paddle on Desolation Sound. And we are located. In case you're thinking about coming this way. Malaspina Inlet. We're going to head out to Feather Cove past Stacy Rocks in search of some seals. So. Yeah. Well, I've still got all my water in here. Maybe that's the water line for these boats.
Yeah, I think it must be.
The what?
The water line.
That must just be where they sit. Everyone's commenting on how low the boats are in the water, but I think... I think they're meant to handle the weight we're packing.
So. Oh, okay. So that's because I'm not much higher.
Okay, so the end of our first day of paddling. We're back from our evening paddle. About to cook up dinner. This incredible view.
Who's here now? We got George,
Simone.
Hello.
And what are we eating? Hot dogs? Is that what you're getting rid of?
Liquid dinner.
Liquid dinner.
I've got crackers and cream cheese. We could bring out some smoked salmon. I still have a little bit left.
Soup?
Soup.
We're doing soup?
Yep. And some worms.
Oh, cool.
And some crab in it.
Yeah. Is Carol on her phone? Trust me, on her phone.
I mean,
okay. That's good. So, gorgeous view. Oh, we're getting a bit of a sunset here. So, I'll get back in a bit if that sunset gets better. But other than that, it's the end of our first day of paddling. Oh, what is... There's something on the water there.
Oh, so much for that.
Yeah, I think a seal just dove down there. Okay, well, until something exciting happens, I'll put the camera down. Here's the situation. We arrived at our campsite and it's full. So we are looking at 4:40 on the clock. We are a minimum of 6 kilometers paddle from the next potential site. No guarantee that is a site. It's a long open ocean crossing again with a storm on its way. We know we're going to be rained in tomorrow. If the sites are all taken at the Kermes, our only other option is another 4.7 to another potential site. So, and if that's full, we're in trouble.